Betty Kamya today chaired an ad hoc meeting of stakeholders in the building sector to address compromise of standards of houses. The meeting that was attended by the Minister of State for Housing, Persis Namuganza, property developers, homeowners, engineers, architects and other local government officials noted concerns of shoddy works by property developers following public outcry.
We have received written complaints from homeowners of apartments in Kasala Masela Apartments, Spices Apartments, Waves Apartments, Leo Zodiac Apartments, Jasmine Courts. We have also received many complaints from the Ugandan diaspora.
Most complaints include poor quality building materials, leakages from the ceilings, inferior plumbing, poor quality electrical equipment and wiring, poor sewage system, among others. Kamya noted that public organs mandated to regulate the sector are being reluctant.
Developers are unhappy home owners. They have a lot of grievances.
Namuganza told the meeting about her investigation on five property developing companies over the integrity of properties sold to Ugandans following numerous petitions from the public.
I was petitioned when they had put up very substandard houses. And when the tenants entered, hardly, yeah, the houses started depreciating. They hear cement and that sound falling off.
However, Namuganza pointed at weaknesses within the law which provide for light penalties that can't compel errant developers to reform. But she assured the public that the real estate bill is in offing to address gaps.
If we have this real estate bill, because for it it's coming with real harsh punishments, that this developer, if is found putting up houses away from the agreed standards, they can hardly be dealt with.
Representatives of an association of Ugandans in diaspora who buy property in Uganda told the meeting that their clients have lost interest in investing in Uganda because of a number of scams reported.
I am an owner personally in Uganda, but I've refused to invest in Uganda in the housing sector because I don't trust the system at all. None of these agencies represented here do I trust. I would rather invest in Nigeria, in Ghana, in Botswana, in Zambia and other places.
Housing Finance Bank was also put on the spot for playing syndicate with quack developers to fleece Ugandans by delivering substandard houses.
The sector of housing, we'd like to know what the technical people are doing when Ugandans are being duped.
We have a memorandum of understanding that stipulates our obligations at the bank and the developer.
According to the National Building Review Board Executive Secretary, the recent study found grave amounts of shoddy works on developed properties. Property developers distanced themselves from most grievances raised by complainants, blaming the problem to poor handling of houses.
I also don't want us to lose the whole issue by painting all developers as devils and bloodsuckers, because it's not true.
However, they could not run away from all queries, saying they have been in position to rectify defects that arise within the defects liability period. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.